Hey everyone, I'm Angela Fazio.
And I'm Kristen Cantrell, and this is Moms in Real Estate, our spinoff, which is Girl Educate Yourself.
We're so excited for today's guest. Her name is Dani Miller, and she's going to talk to us about how she's connecting through social media.
Hey, Dani.
Hey, Dani, how are you?
Hey, how are you guys doing today?
We're doing so good. Thank you so much for being a guest with us.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for inviting me.
Well, I love this topic because in my opinion, God gave her a superpower and about connecting, and I'm always in awe of it. So I can't wait to hear your perspective of connecting through social media. So get us started.
Yeah, for sure. As far as connecting social media, I kind of tell people or tease people all the time, especially when I'm mentoring someone, that I'm a Facebook stalker. You know, I probably have over 2,000 connections on Facebook, which, you know, I mean, anybody that asks, unless they're a creeper or something like that, I usually will say yes, because you just never know when that deal can come to you through a friend of a friend of a friend, you know. And so a lot of things that I do or spend my time doing when I'm connecting on social media is I have a top 20. So there you can go into Facebook and you can pick like a top 20 people to follow. And I normally will pick the people who have given me referrals in the past, or they, you know, somehow really do well, I guess, with my real estate business.
I had no clue you can do that.
Yeah, I knew
you could like categorize the top 20.
Yeah. Well, I think you could probably pick as many as you want. I try to maintain 20, if that makes sense.
Where do you do that?
In the settings, like I think where you follow people, you can like star like so many people you to like follow, you know, because sometimes even when you follow someone, sometimes it shows up all the time and sometimes it doesn't. And normally I try to do that with like I said, the people who give me the most referrals or I've gotten the most business from, you know, just to stay on top of mind for them.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And so I love that idea.
Yeah. I call it stalking because it's like you technically, I look for things where I have the opportunities to throw something in there. You know, someone who needs prayers, someone who his daughter just won the spelling bee at school. You know, I mean, those types of things that I'm looking for, you know what I mean? Or some way to connect with the people, to make a comment, you know, as often as I can. Because I'm a human being and I'm really interested in people's lives anyway, and I care. So it makes it easy for me. Like it's not a struggle. It's not something where I'm sitting there going, oh God, I got to comment on this person's thing.
It's not like it's disingenuous. Like you're like, oh,
right.
She's getting married and you really care. Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And I'm genuinely interested. Like I had a girl who, I had sold her and her ex-husband a house, and then she met another guy. They bought a house or she moved in with him. They didn't use me, but they got married and I sent her a $25 gift card, you know, in the mail. So, you know, stuff like that, where if I see something, I see somebody's grandma died or I send a card. So follow up that way. Like I literally love following up by mail because I really feel a lot of people don't do that these days. You know, and so I've genuinely always been the kind of person who loves cards. Like I love getting cards. I love sending cards.
I have something. Well, I really would like some advice on that because I really want to do that. I actually did it this week.
You did.
Yeah, high five. I know.
Yeah.
But I have like a goal to send another one. Like I just can't stay on top of it.
I know.
How do you do that?
Wait a minute though. The whole thing is to be authentic. And if that is not an authentic way of how you do things, I don't think you should put the pressure on yourself
like,
to do it.
I text them, but I do love getting a card. So I don't know.
I don't love getting the cards unless there's something personal in it.
Well, yeah, and it would be.
And it literally has to be something you're comfortable with. You know what I mean? Like I'm not a comfortable cold caller. I'm not a comfortable, I hate open houses. But like, I've always been the card sender, you know, when I left Arizona to come to college, I left Indiana to come to college in Arizona, like that was the way I stayed in touch with all my family. Like I loved sending my grandma, my mom, you know what I mean? My best friend cards all the time. And so it's something that I just enjoy doing. It's natural for me. So that's one thing I would say, like, don't force yourself to do something that you don't want to do, because then that's when it becomes not genuine. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
or you feel like, oh, I got to
totally
do this,
true.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. One of the things that I love about what you said is the way that you have like your top 20 or whatever in Facebook is I think we all know that nationally only 4% of real estate agents do anything effective, process and procedure around their center of influence. And you right. found a way on Facebook, which I'm like, I'm not even a great Facebook person, but I'll be finding people,
right?
Because that is literally like saying a database, mm-hmm. starring yes. them or whatever you did in Facebook. Yep. And so that you can authentically, that's like drop the mic information right there, Dani Miller. Like, that's awesome.
Well, and one of the things I will tell you, I'm not good at is CRMs. Like, I literally mm-hmm. do not have a CRM. I do not use a CRM. I have a list of people and, you know, I follow them when it's their birthday on Facebook. If I have their phone number, I text them also, you know, so that they see that, you know, it's not just me through Facebook going, oh, it's your birthday. You know what I mean? So I had a couple of teachers at the school. One of them, their mom died. One of them that, their grandmother died, and neither one of them have bought or sold houses from me. But you know, everybody, I mean, as a realtor, we can look up people's addresses in the MLS, but the tax records, you know what I mean? So I literally sent both of them cards. Not that they've ever bought a house. They've never given a referral to me, but they're teachers that I've worked with because I was on the PTA for 4 years. And you see when somebody posts that on Facebook, instead of just on Facebook, oh, your dog died. Oh, your grandma died. You know what I mean? Like, I literally send a physical card. And the Dollar Tree is probably the best place you could possibly go. Their cards are $2 for $1. I mean, you literally, you can go and buy all different occasions, get well, pet
Wait
loss.
A minute. Yes. There's something in Dollar Tree that's not actually a dollar.
Right. All of, well, they have a really? Dollar card mm-hmm. section, but they have a whole section that their cards are $2 for $1.
Nice. Yep. Wow. That just busted awesome. My theory.
Yeah.
You're and you can get all kinds of good golden nuggets.
Yeah. There's Tell so us many more things about you can do. And then I have a box and I have them all categorized. So it's like birthday, get well, sympathy, pet loss, encouragement, you know, anything like congratulations. Awesome. Maybe somebody graduated, or like I have a neighbor right now who she just went to vet tech school and she just graduated. So I'm going to send her a card. You know what I mean? So, I mean, it's just one of those things, but I'm a card person. So I get excited about it, you know, and it's so just a way to follow up.
Yeah. And I do like, and so like you're saying, it would be, I don't do cards because it's not me, right?
Right.
So what I do is when I see something on Facebook, like whatever it is, instead of writing them on the comments, I always go to text
them.
I'm like, hey, I just saw this. That's so cool. That way I can have that personal engagement. I don't even do a DM or anything like that. I'm like, I go straight to text if I know them.
And if you have their phone number, that's the best way to do it. You know?
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I use my Animoji and sing happy birthday to them through my Animoji.
I believe it.
I totally do. Yep. I'm completely nerdy.
She's always sending me Animojis.
Right? It looks just like me. I swear.
Oh, that's cool. I know the one on my phone doesn't look like me at all, I don't think. But hey,
Mine doesn't either.
I don't send it very often.
So tell us some more tips about Facebook and how you connect through there.
Yep. And so, you know, when you're on Facebook, that's, you know, another way to do it. I either give a message there, or like I said, if I have their address, I'll send them a physical card. If it's something important, I mean, if it's just something like to say, hey, congratulations, or somebody needs prayers and you just want to say, you know, praying for you or thinking about you, then I'll do that. If I have like Kristen said, you know what I mean? If you have their phone number, text them. I do that too with birthdays. You know, it's like, I don't necessarily send everybody a birthday card, but if I'm friends with them on Facebook, instead of just on Facebook saying happy birthday, I'll text them, you know, cause it just means you're top of mind thinking about them a little more than, oh, it popped up in your Facebook feed as the 5 birthdays today. You know what I mean? It's a little bit more personal, I guess, like she mm-hmm. said, when you text. So
Absolutely. Yeah.
And it's basically staying connected with people. You know, I mean, I've done so many marketing things and lead services, and I've been on the grocery carts at Albertsons and, you know, years ago. And I mean, just different ways, you know, I'm on the tables at Santan Cafe in Santan Valley or Queen Creek, wherever you want to call it. Like, I'm on the tables in an advertisement. I'm in Mount Athos on an advertisement. And it's recognition, but when you can connect personally with someone, then that recognition is 10 times better. I don't know how many people have ate at Santan Cafe off of Santan Boulevard in Power and have sent me a picture of myself off the table. Hey, I'm eating breakfast with you. You know what I mean?
That's cute. So,
right? They're recognizing mm-hmm. me, but I stay involved in these people's lives, even though it might take me, and I probably spend more time on social media than I need to, but I sell a lot of houses because of it, because I'm connecting mm-hmm. with people, you know what I mean? And I'm being that genuine, true person, you know, that can connect. And I mean, I have a blog. I don't know if you guys have ever read it, but I do a lot of stuff that happens in my personal life and I throw it out there because I'm a writer. I hate video. I'll tell you that right now. I'm looking at myself going, oh my God, I can't believe I look like that today.
You look good.
But you know, writing is my passion. I love writing. And so I blog as much as I can about personal situations that if I can help one other person or one other mom look at it and go like, oh my God, that happened to her too. I'm not the crazy one. You know what I mean? That is important. So I post that on my social media as well so that, you know, someone happens to read it and it helps them through their tough day. You know, I have that as well. But, you know, just connect in any way that's comfortable for you. You know, like you're more of a texter, I'm more of a card sender, you know, so. Mm-hmm.
Well, and I think that's one of the coolest takeaways is sometimes you feel like when you get into real estate, it's this box and you need to be doing cold calling and you need to be doing door knocking and open houses. And no, you don't. You can find a way that really is authentic to you and you won't get burnt out, right? So you have been in real estate for how long and you're probably having the best time because you're connecting and you genuinely like to connect.
Yeah, this is actually my 20th year.
Wow, same. Yeah. So we were just talking on Midweek Mind Freak yesterday about finding your sweet spot. And that's what you're doing. Like the cards, it makes you feel filled with joy to do that. You know, the way that you're connecting on Facebook, it makes you happy to do that. You're working in your sweet spot. And that's why you're selling lots of houses because you found it and you're not trying to force, you know, something that's not genuine to you.
And I've learned marketing over the years. Like I've spent so much money on other things trying to pull people in for me. You know, I had 48 transactions last year and I didn't have a single one of them that wasn't a referral. You know what I mean? They weren't from some outside source. They weren't, you know, and so the money that I've spent in those places, I'm like, okay, I need to hone that money back in and spend it on my sphere of influence or my past clients or the people that give me referrals. So
that's awesome. Well, I always love getting to talk to you. If you had to give, let's say a new agent or an agent that maybe needs a little bit of advice, what advice would you give them?
Well, I would say if they don't know what their passion is or they don't know, you know, how to work, when you very first get started, you should probably try everything, you know, try open houses, try calling, try, you know, marketing to your sphere of influence, try calling people that you know, that sort of stuff. But, you know, if you can get a mentor who's been there, done that and didn't succeed and you can kind of have coffee with five or six people who do different things, you're going to take away something from every single one of those persons that you're going to be able to bring back and be like, I think I could do this. I think I could do that. I don't want to do that. You know what I mean? And then I think that helps people hone in into the fact of what they really are passionate about because we're all different. I mean, there's plenty of business out there. I mean, maybe not right now with the low inventory, but there's plenty of business out there for everybody, you know? And so I don't ever feel like someone's technically my competition, you know? So I always tell people, if you, you know, I love coffee, I love wine. If you take me, you know, I love lunch. So take me.
Today's National Wine Day.
So there's an excuse to drink wine.
Man, yeah, finally an excuse to drink wine.
It's an excuse today though, because it's National Wine Day, right?
That's literally like so funny that you said that because I really was like, what do I like to do and how do I build my business around it? And I literally was like, I like coffee, I like wine. I'm gonna have appointments with coffee and wine all week. Yeah. And that's what I do.
And that's how you connect with people. So there's so many different ways to connect with people. You just gotta find your niche. You know, because like I tell people all the time, if they, like, I have a guy right now who's calling me today about mentoring and I told him, hey, let's have a conversation over the phone, see if we're a match, because you're not always a match with everybody, you know? And so therefore the things that you do, you're going to hone in on those types of people who like what you're doing or giving them, you know, because somebody asked me, I know I have a couple minutes, but somebody asked me the other day, like what I do is like closing gifts. And I'm pretty good at, specializing in it. You know what I mean? If I know somebody's getting a pool, I'm going to get them a huge basket with all this pool stuff. If I know somebody's into, you know, this or that, I try not to single out and make it, you know, one size fits all. So I get to know my clients and what their likes and dislikes are. And hopefully I will tell you in all the years, almost all of them are still my friend, you know? And so
that's so great.
Yep.
Well, you are awesome at what you do. And we appreciate you so much coming on and teaching all the moms in real estate all around the US. And
Thank you so much, Dani.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Talk to you guys soon.
All right. Bye. See ya. Thank you.